Can't take too much of your time. There's one fight that a lot of people want to see, and that is David Benavidez and Caleb Plant. They don't like each other. They're both champions. They're both at 68. What is the chance of that happening soon?
Man, you know, like I said, I've been doing a lot of interviews about that. You know, he says that he wants to fight David. He doesn't want to fight David. You know, the when he won it, he said, hey, I'm tired of chasing David. I reached out to the promotion company, you know, and his managers, you know, we want to make that fight, you know. I mean, I think we could beat him. I think we could beat him, you know. Don't get me wrong. He's a good fighter, you know. But I think in my heart, I think we could beat him. I want that fight. We've been pushing for that fight, you know. And for some reason, it's not happening, you know. He's not ready. He's not ready, you know.
What do you think? How do you see the fight unfolding? Caleb Plant's a good boxer. He's slick. He moves.
Very slick. Very slick fighter. You know, I've been studying him. You know, I think he has, you know, like he thinks, you know, that he has a lot of opportunities to beat David. I think he sees a lot of mistakes that David does, but we see a lot of mistakes that he does, you know. But, you know, I'm going to tell you simple as, you know, like I've been telling people, you know, there's no secrets. Do you think that Caleb Plant is going to stay and trade with David? No way. There's no way. You know, he's going to try to use his skills, you know, be slick, you know, try to throw the jab. Combinations and move back, left, right, you know. So our job is to, you know, come. What we got to do, we got to work that body, man. We got to work that body. We got to work that the chest, you know. We got to put him back to the ropes. And, you know, don't let him out, you know. And it's going to be a little hard. It's not going to be super easy because he's good at what he does, you know. But right here, what's gonna play the role is, you know, who's more smarter, you know. He thinks he's more smarter. But, you know, when you get hit in the body and you can't run anymore, what do you do? What do you do when you don't have the legs no more, you know? So we're going to concentrate a lot on, you know, if we were to fight him, we're going to concentrate. No secrets, like I say, you know. We're going to attack that body. We're going to attack that chest. When he covers, we're going to attack those arms, you know. And then when he doesn't have anything, you know, we're going to attack that face, and that's when he's going to drop and go to the ground, you know. And then that's when he's going to realize, you know, that, you know, he wasn't ready for David, you know. But it's not going to be easy. Don't get me wrong. Like I said, he's a good fighter. He has a lot of skills. But if you don't think that way, you know, I think we got, you know, I think we have what is needed to be for him to get beat, you know. So he thinks the same, you know. So let's do it. Let's make that fight, you know. Let's get the fight that people want, you know.
Why is there beef between? I remember visiting a gym and both of you guys were training at the gym at the same time. Obviously,
yeah,
something
man,
happened.
You know, the only thing, you know, he makes a lot of drama. You know, he's crazy. He talks a lot of stuff, you know. I like that guy, you know. You know, I have a lot of respect for the trainers, man. They're very good people. The only person, you know, he just, for some reason, he's very jealous of David. I don't know why, man. To be honest with you, he's super jealous about him. Maybe because he has more knockouts, he has more fights, he gets paid more money than him. But to me, I mean, I don't know why, you know. To be honest, I have no idea, you know. I used to talk to the guy, you know, when David got positive for drugs, you know, that's when he started saying a lot. And, you know, and I got hurt up because of that, because he's my son, you know. And I went up to him and I told him, dude, you know, just stop that drug thing, you know, and all that, please, you know, I'm begging you, you know. And he says, yes, okay, no problem. And, you know, but I could tell him, say whatever you want to say, you know, you're going to knock him out, you're going to do whatever, but please, you know, just the drugs, man, it's killing me, it's hurting me, you know. And, you know, he started saying, you know, that I came up with the idea, you know, that he's always using his daughter. And like I said, you know, I was mad. Maybe I did say it. I don't remember, you know. I said something about that, you know, that he was using his daughter. And I apologize, you know. I'm a man, you know. I can admit, you know, that I, you know, she's a little angel, you know. She has nothing to do with it. Rest in peace, you know. But like I said, you know, I apologize for that if I did, you know. But... you know, when I went to, you know, I was reading something about the real truth about Caleb Plant, you know, that everybody knows. I didn't make that up, you know. I went there and I started reading, you know, the some writer came up with all the stories of what happened. I had no respect for this man, you know, because, I mean, they're saying there that all that would happen there, you know. So, I mean, that's what it is, you know. So I have no respect for this guy, you know, and I didn't want to fight nobody like him. You know, we want to fight this guy, you know, because of a lot of things, you know, and the fight that we really want, that's the fight that we really want, you know? So hopefully it happens, and we'll see.
It's safe to say there will be no face-off before this fight. They'll save it for the ring.
Man, you know, hopefully there is, you know, because, I mean, I mean, that's what makes it more interesting, you know, and more, it'll motivate both of us, you know, to give a good show, you know. I mean, now I'm starting to talk a lot of shit. I wasn't like this, you know, but I feel disrespected, you know. And, you know, if you see now, you know, I just got to defend myself, you know. Like I said, you know, now it's personal, you know. Man, you know, that would be the happiest moment of my life when we fight Cali Plant.